Hi students, and welcome back to another e-lesson video, this one over the modes of discourse. As with all of these videos, please feel free to pause, rewind at any time to take notes, rewatch, or catch up. And this is a pretty short video. We're just going to talk about the four rhetorical modes, also known as the modes of discourse, and why we are studying them. The four rhetorical modes, also known as the four modes of discourse, define the four different aims of writing, that is, the four different goals that every writer has when trying to compose a text. The four rhetorical modes originated in the 19th century in some British and American textbooks and became the core of English language arts education in Britain and America up until about the 70s, when the four rhetorical modes slowly started fading from at least American textbooks, along with a lot of all the other things that made English language arts curriculum great, such as formal logic and the hardcore rhetoric that we used to teach that we don't so much anymore. Anyway, that's not the point of this video. The four rhetorical modes are narration, description, exposition, and argumentation. So let's take a look at what each one of those are. Narration. This is exactly what it sounds like. Narration is writing used to relate a sequence of events. We see this, of course, in fiction. We see this, of course, in drama. We also see this, though, in nonfiction, when authors need to relate a series of events in order to get their point across. We even see this in poetry. Poems also often tell a story. And so anytime an author uses writing to relate to the reader a series of events, that is narration. Description, that's the next one. Description is writing used to describe a person, place, or thing through sensory details. Description may be objective or impressionistic, a couple different ways to for the descriptive mode to be used. The objective descriptive mode is when you are literal or factual in your depiction. That is, independent of the author's feelings. When you want to describe something just as it is or appears to be without providing any sort of personal perceptions of it, that is an objective description. Descriptive writing, though, can also be impressionistic, meaning you're not so much trying to convey literal or factual depictions. You're trying to convey the various moods or feelings that a thing evokes. Impressionistic descriptions do not so much inform as much as they sort of arouse emotion or arouse some sort of abstract sensations. So keep in mind that a description as a mode comes in a couple different varieties, the literal as well as the impressionistic, the objective and the impressionistic. Exposition, this is writing used to inform and explain. Analysis is the most common form of exposition or expository writing in high school English. And finally, argumentation, which you should all be familiar with. This is writing used to declaim a truth or falsehood. It's writing used to persuade. It is the most sophisticated mode of rhetoric because it often relies on narration, description, and exposition in order to get your point across, in order to argue. Why do we study these four rhetorical modes? Since they're, you know, pretty simple concepts, four different reasons why we write. Sure, that makes sense. We study them because some textbooks still teach each mode as its own genre of essay. And in fact, on our state tests, we still do this. I believe freshmen are still required to write a narrative essay and a persuasive essay, something like that. Sophomores a persuasive and an analytical essay, etc. So so it's still necessary to teach each mode as its own genre, so to speak. We sort of do this in FISD to prepare you for these state tests. The most important thing that you need to know as AP students about these modes, why we study them, is that while one mode may dominate a text, other modes may be present. Okay, we often combine modes, we often overlap modes to produce something worthwhile. It's really difficult to write something that is purely argumentative without explaining anything or without narrating anything up front. In fact, that creates a pretty bland or pretty confusing text. And so this is the most important reason why we study them, is so that we can identify, it helps us better understand how a text is put together. If we can point to a particular passage and say, hey, the point behind what he's saying here is to provide narration, to get us caught up to speed before he starts his primary argument. Or the point here, these few paragraphs are all expository, just giving us the information and the definitions we need to know to better understand the argument he's about to present, that sort of thing. We studied rhetorical modes in AP Lang. I kind of hinted at this already. So we can better analyze how a text is written, and so we can write more effective texts of our own. Once we start learning how to recognize these four rhetorical modes as they are, as we see in professional writing, we can start incorporating those various strategies into our own writing. I had very few students on our first, even our first draft of the researched argument essay, who gave me any sort of narration or exposition. A lot of times students just assumed that I, the reader, would know about what they were talking about, what they were trying to get across, and that's not necessarily the case. We can't assume that sort of thing with any reader, even myself. So a lot of it was kind of lacking some key narrative or key expository elements that could have really helped. In other essays, I saw some essays that, while they were supposed to be argumentative in nature, they were dominated by exposition. And so being able to just see all of that unnecessary exposition, or at least see how very little of your argumentative essay is actual argument, can help us write more effectively. I told you this was a short video. That's really all you need to know. The four modes of discourse, they overlap. We're talking about narration, description, exposition, and argumentation. Thank you for watching. Feel free to watch again. Go ahead and move on to the assignment that goes with this, where you actually analyze some of the modes of discourse in Frederick Douglass.